Hello, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today I'm going to give you a strategy for a great way to not only play the perfect notes for a chord, but to be able to do it using an incredibly simple approach that you'll nail down perfectly in only a couple of days. And to do this, all you're going to need are three easy shapes in major that we're going to go over in detail during this lesson. After this, join me on Patreon for the second half of this lesson, and you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'll be taking things further with our three notes lick approach. I'll show you other options for how it can be used in the tonality of minor, and I'll put these shapes to work within a melody over top of a specific music style. Once we're all done, you'll have a large collection of three note licks for your next guitar solo. Now let's begin by playing three shapes that show where these licks will actually come from. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. Before we start to come up with these three-note licks, we're going to first base everything off of a popular three-note chord that's called the triad. Now, triad chord shapes are available all over the guitar fingerboard, but we're going to keep things really simple today by using three common triad shapes that are set up in the middle of the neck. So these three-note shapes that I have for you, they're going to be A, E, and D. All right, so let's just look at these individually to get started with here. The first one is our A shape, and this is all set up in the key A major, so this is our root chord. So we're going off of the fourth guitar string at the seventh fret with the third finger, and then we're using the middle finger here on the C sharp note. It's third string on the sixth fret. And then we've got this high E. It's set up here on the second string at the fifth fret. It makes for a nice diagonal shape. It's really easy to play. Now the next one is our E chord. In this shape here, we're going from the 6th fret of the 4th string with the 3rd finger over here to a B note with the index finger on the 4th fret of the 3rd string, and then we'll have our middle finger up here on an E root that'll take place on the 5th fret of the 2nd string. Another fairly easy shape. And then for the D chord, we're going to have a bar that we'll do up here at the 7th fret area, and that's going to cover 4th, 3rd, and 2nd guitar strings. We have an A, a D, and an F sharp up top there. The D is on the 3rd string, 7th fret. And up here, we're going to add on one extra note. It's an octave of an A, and so we're going to add that in as an option. But you have to realize, if you add that note in, it is a really great note to add to this chord shape, but it does block out the chord's major third, which is the F sharp. So we do lose that note if you add it in. So if you add it, you just maybe want to have it for a melody line or something, you know, on and then take it off. All right, so those are our three chords, A, E, and D. It's the root, fifth chord, and fourth chord of the key of A major. So let's go over an exercise now where you can put these to use and just get them technically into your guitar playing. The exercise is really simple. It just goes like this. So you see the focus there of getting to the end and hitting an open A fifth string just to kind of, you know, lock down the sound of the key. So the chord changes are moving by going A, E, D with both of its options, and then over to E again, D, and A with that low fifth string open in the bass. Now, if you probably noticed there in the beginning when I was going into the D chord, I was using my first finger, but then later when I was finishing things up, just before heading back to the root chord of A, I did a bar with my third finger on that seventh fret layout there for the D shape. Keep that in mind, because as you're jamming out on ideas, whether it's melodies or it's maybe even a chord jam or something like that, you may sometimes need to do that bar with your index and then other times do it with your third finger. So what we're going to do now is take a short break. We're going to be coming back with some example licks for you so you can get some guitar licks going on out of these chord shapes. They're really great shapes because they track into the tonality of the chord so perfectly, and it gives you all the chord tones. It's really going to be a fun idea to mess around with. And then when we catch up again on the Patreon lesson, we're going to go through some minor tonality setups on this stuff. Plus, I've got a really cool melody line that I'm going to basically take all these ideas and put them into work for you. And it's going to be stylistic too. I got a really nice reggae jam that we're going to be taking a look at with all this stuff. So it should be a lot of fun on Patreon coming up after things. But right now, let's take a short break and then come back with some melodies and some licks that I got for you set up out of this exact idea here with these chord changes. Now that we've established the collection of triad shapes, our next step will be to use them to format a series of licks that can work in this key of A major. Now also keep in mind that you can use these licks across any key that you would want to build three note licks off of. The example licks that I have for you coming up next will work from off the chords that we just went over. So after learning these licks, try creating some of your own original three note licks as well. Our first example is going to be two chord coverage covering an A major and a D major chord. The idea for the licks goes like this. So the starting idea, which is covering the sound of A major, is just coming at that shape, which is that diagonal that we had just looked at for the A major shape. It just goes on the 6th and 7th frets of 3rd and 4th strings, and then it jumps over to 2nd string, gets a 5th fret note, sustains it for a moment. We hit two notes together with a 6 and a 5, 3rd and 2nd strings, and that pretty much wraps up what's happening for the A major. Then what happens is the D is coming in next, so we're going to move up, go into the 7th fret of 2nd string here, play that note, let it sustain over into the next measure. We'll grab a 10th fret A note, remember that one, that was our extended note of the upper octave for A, and then we're going to slide backward on the 2nd string from 7 to 5, then go to the 3rd string 4th fret, hit this note, and then move forward 5 to 7, bring back in a D here on the 3rd string 7th fret. So that 2nd measure is like... All right, you put them both together and you get this. All right, so that's the first example I have for you. Now I have another example as well, but this one is going to be moving through the chords of A major into E down to D. So it's your typical 1-5-4 chord progression. Now, this melody and, you know, the encompassing licks that surround it goes like this. So you can really hear the outlines of those chords there, starting with A, into this E coming up next, you can hear that in there, then the D chord, you can really hear that one too, huh? Sounds great. So now let's go over these licks just to teach them to you. We start off out of that first shape, which of course is the A major, the diagonal shape. So we're going in reverse from the upper string, 2nd string. We're going 5 into 3rd string, 6 into 4th string, 7th fret. Then we come back to the 6 and then back to the 5. Now that's a kind of a crossover note, that 5 on the 2nd string, because it's an E, so it works as the perfect 5th of the A chord, and also the root, obviously, of our E chord. So we're just going to sustain on that for a bit, and then we're going to bring in our other notes of the E chord, which is the B and the G sharp. So it's a really strong sound when you're getting into that E major effect. So that covers the first measure of the E and the A and the E chord. Now remember, that second measure is all D major. So when we're on that second measure, we're moving in by way of a 6th fret to a 7th fret, kind of a quick movement there, and we're bringing in the sound, because we're leaving an E, so the G sharp's leaving and coming along into an A, and that A is an important note for the D chord, perfect 5th. Just just going right across that D chord sound. Remember that barring stuff we had talked about when we were discussing the shapes themselves? Just like that. So we're covering that layout, and then we're going to bring in a 10th fret note on the second string. So we have that hit two times. That's that high A. And then we're just bringing back around again, F sharp and D once more. So the movement across the D chord is really giving us that impact of that D major sound, and then high A is just nice to round things out. Perfect fifth note in there. Back to that F sharp, which is a really strong tone because it's the major third of that D chord, and then just back around having the D and the A come, you know, back. Well, actually the A doesn't return. It's a 7th fret D is our final return note there. We're up in the A, and then we go F sharp, and then into the D, the root of the chord. So now we've covered our A, E, D sound with those licks. All right, so this is how easy this stuff can be. I mean, really, it's just small chord shapes. We take a look at how things are set up on the neck, and then if we have chord changes, you know, that are following suit with these particular harmonies, we just invent little statements that go around, you know, off of each chord type. It's really a great sound. Now, in the lesson here, we've gone over major, but what we're going to do coming up next in the Patreon is we're going to cover the sounds again, but in minor, so you have that, you know, all, you know, tied up as well for yourself. And then from there, like I had mentioned earlier, we are going to check out a melody that I put together with all these triad concepts. And it's going to cover the sounds of a really nice reggae jam in minor. So it's a lot of fun coming up in the Patreon lesson. I hope to see you there next. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'll be taking things further with our three-note lick approach, and I'll show you other options for how they can be used in the tonality of minor. Plus, I'll put these shapes to work across a melody for a specific music style. Once we're all done, you'll have a large collection of great three-note licks that you can use in your next guitar solos. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get two jam tracks, and you'll also be able to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.